guys, this is Gaurav. So in this session, we are going to talk about inter-VLAN routing, but not on a single link. Here, we are going to do something different configuration with dual link, okay? So now, in the last session, we already know about how to configure inter-VLAN routing on a single link. For that purpose, what we did, we have created some sub-interface here. So as you can see here, if you want to learn how to do this configuration, so go and check it out, my old video which I have uploaded on my YouTube channel. Now next one, here what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove this router, okay? So here is the something new. So here is my new router where I'm going to connect switch to router. This is the single link and this is the another link which I am going to add. Okay, so now what I'm going to do here, same concept about inter-VLAN routing, router on stick. So VLAN 1 should be communicated with VLAN 20 users. Okay, so in VLAN 10 there's a two users, 1.1.1.1. second one is a 1.1.1.2, and this side 2.2.2.1 and 2.2.2.2. okay, so now how we need to configure with the help of two link. So let's get started. So first of all, let me jump on this particular router. Before that, in a previous configuration, what I have done some basic configuration on my switch regarding trunk. So first of all, I will have to remove that one. So this is the interface which I have configured in the trunk. So I am going to remove that configuration, switchboard mode trunk. Simply I will put no switchboard mode trunk. Okay, so now you can see I have removed that configuration. So this is the complete case configuration. Let me tell you what I have done the basic configuration. First of all, I have done the basic IP address configuration on all four users. Two users are belonging to VLAN 10 and two users are belonging from VLAN 20. Okay, so on a switch level, what I have done, I have created some VLANs, VLAN 10 and VLAN 20. VLAN 10 name is yellow and VLAN 20 name is orange. For this practical, we need a prerequisite knowledge about the VLAN and trunk. Okay, trunk is not required for this practical, but if it is having, that's a good thing. So now you can see switch is already configured and that these user PCs are already configured, as well as I have configured gateways also. Okay, so now you can see here, in a previous configuration we have only one link. Okay, so on that single link we are passing a two different VLANs traffic. That means we have to configure in a trunk mode. Okay, that's why I configured in a trunk. But here we have two links. This is my first link F0/0 and here is my second link F0/1. So what I'm going to do here, so I'm going to send my VLAN traffic, VLAN 10 traffic from this interface F0/0. So I'm going to put IP address 10.10.10.10 and F0/1 20.1.1.10 as well as F0/3 and 0/6. Don't worry about this, we are going to configure this interface, but not now. Okay, so let's get started. So first of all, here is a two separate link. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are sending a traffic, VLAN 10 traffic from interface F0/0 and VLAN 20 traffic from interface FA0/1. So that's why I'm going to configure. Simple basic configuration you have to do, no encapsulation .1q command that we have used in a previous practical. 10.1.1.10 255.255.2, this is the class A, no shutdown. Same thing I will have to configure on another interface, 20.1.1.10 255.0.0.0, no shutdown. Okay, right now what I have done, I have configured both the interfaces on the router. Now you can see these two interfaces are connected to this switch. This switch is a F0/3 and the 0/4, 6, these ports are connected to the router. So what configuration we have to configure on this interface? That's a big question. If you go to my previous practical, so there is only one interface. Okay, so the same interface, who is traveling, who is like sending the VLAN traffic, both VLAN traffic, VLAN 10 and VLAN 20. But here is the situation is different. So here we are having a two different VLAN, VLAN 10 and VLAN 20. So what we are going to do, this interface is passing VLAN 10 traffic and this interface will pass VLAN 20 traffic. So I am going to configure these two interface in access mode. So simple configuration, interface pass Ethernet 0/3, switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 10, and interface F0/6, switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 20. Okay, done. Show VLAN. So now you can see these two interface we have configured in VLAN 10 and 20. Okay, so this interface in VLAN 10 and this interface in VLAN 20. We have to wait for some time. Later we'll check whether VLAN 10 users are able to reach VLAN 20 users or not. We have to wait. Let's see. It should be reached. If it is not reaching, then we have to troubleshoot. Okay, see, it is not reaching, so we have to troubleshoot. Okay, now let me tell you what mistake we have done here. Okay, I know what mistake I have done. So let me tell you. Now you can see here these two user PC. The first user PC IP address is 2.2.2.1 and the second PC user PC IP address is 2.2.2.2. Even I have configured the gateway here 2.2.2.10, but when I have configured on a router F0/1, so here I did 20. So that's a different network. So this is the mistake I have done here. So let me fix this mistake. Instead of 20, I have to put 2. So this is the mistake, configuration mistake. That's a very silly mistake. We have to configure properly. Now interface, even I think so, even here also I did the same mistake, because here you can see 1.1.1.1. I thought it's a 10.1.1.1. That's why I have done this mistakes. Anyways, so let me fix this one. Interface F0/0 IP address 1.1.1.10 25500. No need to remove previous configuration because it will overwrite automatically, so not a problem. We have to learn from our mistake. Okay, so now 2.2.2.1. See, it is reachable now. That means our configuration is correct. This is the second user in VLAN 20. It is reachable. We have to check vice versa. From second, fourth number user, that's belong to VLAN 20. This is the first user. We are getting the reachability. So that means it is working proper. So suppose that if you are performing VLAN inter VLAN routing protocol with the help of dual link, so this is how you need to configure. Suppose that if you have one more VLAN, VLAN 30, so not a problem, you can create this kind of topology and use the third interface. Now here is, there is no another interface, as you can see here only two interface, F0/0 and 0/1. So here you go, here is a turn off this device Ethernet. So again, you just go here and connect it. So you have now three interfaces. Okay, so likewise you can configure, you can take the multiple link and do the multiple VLAN configuration here. So this is the practical, is all about the inter VLAN routing, but not single link. We have done in a dual link. You can try for the three links, four links, so that's possible. So hope you get it. Thank you so much for this session.